So you may notice in a very young child with autism, difficulties shifting gaze between objects and between people. So they may look at you, or more likely they may look at an object, but they often do not shift between looking at you as a parent and looking at, say, something that you're holding. So we sometimes describe these children as being very object focused. So they're really, really intent upon getting a particular object, for example. May not communicate in just in order to share interests or enjoyment. So a typically developing kid will figure out how to point and will be pointing out things and showing you things and wanting you to be experiencing what they're experiencing. A lot of times it has to do with coordinating gestures, sound, and eye gaze. So you may have a child who has some language skills but does not always use them with gestures, or may not sort of communicate fluidly in that sense. Or sometimes they may have unconventional means of communicating. So many of the parents I work with have the experience of having their child, when their child wants something, they'll say to me, well, my kid will come up to me, they'll take my hand and they'll put it on what it is that they want. So that's an unconventional way of communicating. It gets the point across. Parents understand it. But it's not the most efficient way of communicating. Sometimes we see children with language skills that seem to be more advanced than their understanding of language. So they may speak in short phrases, or they may repeat things over and over. We notice children with early signs of object have atypical ways of playing with objects or atypical interests in certain things. So a lot of things like they may be particularly fascinated with fans or air conditioners or things that are not necessarily toys but are very captivating to them. Oftentimes we see that children with autism don't have very good pretend play. Sometimes we can get them to do certain things, but they're not pretending with objects, or they may not be imitating social things that they see other people doing. So feeding a baby, for example, with using a doll, or pretending that a block is a car and driving it around. And sometimes children with autism don't necessarily interact with other people for strictly social purposes, so they tend more to interact with, to get some needs met, like food or comfort or whatever.